My name is Start Loving. I'm one of two people that maintains the 24-hour White House peace vigil that's been going for 30 years. That almost certainly suggests that I have some significant universal love, universal compassion, empathy, solidarity with everyone on the planet. Good and evil, white and black. Without question, this is true of me. And yet, for the first 3 months, I would say, that a gentleman showed up in the park to loudly perform the Muslim call to prayer. It was a negative and intensely negative experience for me. It was so foreign. It was so alien to what I understand. I did not ascribe bad motives. But it was not my guess that there was anything good at work. I hate all the organized religions. They were conceived for good ends, and they have been perverted to almost entirely evil ends. Well, I began to get to know this individual, this gentleman. And he's been repeating this ritual for, I'd say, at least a year, maybe a year and a half, for the privilege of doing so. He lives on the streets. He's educated, maybe highly educated. I've even heard that he was a medical doctor at one point. He's from Turkey, most recently has lived in California. And I've come to know him as one of the 10 or 20 or so people that I can personally name that are out of hundreds and thousands of people that I know. He's one of 10 or 20 I can personally name that is a person of heart, a person of commitment, a person of humanity. I don't agree with his methods, but that's much less important than the fact that it's clear to me that, and as he articulates, that he's doing what he's doing because it's his way of trying to bring, to heal the rift between Americans and Muslims. And for most, I think he achieves the opposite by introducing something so foreign into a setting which is the last place that people would want to see and come to see a foreign religion, a quote foreign religious display. But for people of heart like me, it has been a tremendous learning experience. You know, we know in athletics that that growth requires pain. I think that's a truism. For the nervous system in general, it was painful for me to suspend judgment, to be aware of my own negative response, to be open to see opportunities where I could gather further information with this individual who I now consider a friend, a brother, and he considers me a friend, a brother. When, not too many months ago, this summer, July, I believe, there was a whack job, so-called pastor in...
Thank you. Is the lady still here?
She is, uh-huh. Every day. Thank you, brother. There was a whack whack job pastor in Florida that was going to burn the Koran. A day or so before, I saw on C-SPAN an hour and a half session occurring at that time, where so-called faith leaders from throughout the United States came to condemn, to speak against this planned burning of the Koran. One of them was a rabbi from New York, as I recall, and he said to the effect, the world is not divided into Muslims and Jews and Christians and black and white, rich and poor, American, non-American. The world is divided into good people and bad people. People of love, people of exploitation and abuse. And that's just how it is.